Ever found yourself coughing and then out of nowhere, there's this unmistakable taste of blood in your mouth? It's pretty unsettling, right? Before you start going down a WebMD rabbit hole and diagnosing yourself with every ailment under the sun, let's talk about why this happens. It's more common than you might think and can be caused by a variety of reasons, some benign and others needing a bit more attention. In this video, we'll explore the usual suspects behind the blood taste phenomenon during a coughing fit and when it might be time to consult a healthcare professional. So if you're ready, let's get into it. Now, you're probably wondering, is it normal to taste blood when coughing? The answer is no. Tasting blood when coughing isn't exactly normal, but it isn't always a sign of a severe condition either. This sensation often stems from minor issues like the rupture of small blood vessels in the throat or nasal passages due to intense coughing. Such occurrences can lead to a slight mix of blood with saliva, which might taste metallic or blood-like. Dry conditions, infections, and inflammation within the respiratory system can also make tissues more susceptible to minor bleeding during a bout of coughing. While the experience can be unsettling, it's typically not a cause for alarm if it happens rarely, in the absence of other symptoms. However, it's crucial to remain vigilant. If the taste of blood during coughing is persistent, accompanies a significant amount of blood, or is joined by other worrying symptoms such as chest pain or ongoing respiratory issues, it's important to consult a healthcare provider. In such cases, this symptom could indicate more serious conditions that require medical attention. You may have heard this symptom referred to as hemoptysis. Hemoptysis refers to the act of coughing up blood or blood-streaked sputum from the lungs or bronchial tubes, signaling an underlying condition within the respiratory tract. This symptom can range from small amounts of blood-streaked phlegm to larger quantities of pure blood, varying significantly in severity. In general, hemoptysis occurs when blood vessels in the lungs or bronchial tubes are compromised, leading to bleeding in the respiratory tract. Common causes include infections like bronchitis or pneumonia, where infection can cause blood vessels to rupture. Lung cancer is another significant cause, as tumor growth can erode into the airways or blood vessels. Chronic diseases such as tuberculosis, pulmonary embolism, and cystic fibrosis can also lead to hemoptysis by damaging lung tissue or causing persistent inflammation. Additionally, autoimmune conditions like vasculitis, where the body's immune system attacks its own blood vessels, can provoke bleeding in the lungs. Even outside of these conditions, trauma to the chest from accidents or surgical procedures can cause internal bleeding manifesting as hemoptysis. Hemoptysis is considered a serious symptom, requiring immediate medical evaluation to determine its cause. Its significance in diagnosing and treating underlying conditions makes it a critical symptom that healthcare professionals pay close attention to during patient assessments. Preventing the taste of blood when coughing involves addressing the root causes and maintaining good respiratory health. Since a common reason for this symptom is irritation or minor bleeding in the throat and lungs due to persistent coughing, keeping the airways moist and reducing inflammation is key. Hydrating well, using humidifiers to moisten dry air, and avoiding irritants like smoke and pollution can help protect your respiratory tissues. If allergies or infections are to blame, seeking appropriate treatment to manage these conditions can prevent the coughing that leads to the taste of blood. For those with chronic conditions like bronchitis or asthma, following a doctor-prescribed management plan is crucial. This may include medications to reduce inflammation, prevent infections, and alleviate coughing. Additionally, practicing good hygiene to avoid respiratory infections and getting vaccinated against flu and pneumococcal pneumonia can also be protective measures. Since the causes can vary widely, if experiencing this symptom frequently, it's essential to consult with a healthcare provider for a tailored approach to prevention based on your specific health situation. Tasting blood when you cough can certainly be concerning, but it doesn't always signal a serious health issue. This sensation often arises from minor causes, such as the rupture of small blood vessels in the throat due to intense coughing or a dry, irritated respiratory tract. However, it's important to pay attention to this symptom, especially if it persists, occurs alongside significant amounts of blood, or is accompanied by other symptoms like weight loss, chest pain, or prolonged cough. In these cases, the taste of blood can indicate more serious conditions like infections, lung disease, or even lung cancer, necessitating a prompt medical evaluation. The occasional taste of blood without additional symptoms is usually not a cause for alarm, but staying vigilant and consulting a healthcare provider for persistent or severe cases is crucial for your peace of mind and health. Essentially, while you shouldn't panic, you shouldn't ignore it either. especially if the symptom doesn't resolve or is associated with other signs of illness. And some people often wonder if this symptom is related to COVID-19. In general, tasting blood after coughing is not typically listed among the common symptoms of COVID-19. The primary symptoms associated with COVID-19 include fever, cough, shortness of breath or difficulty breathing, fatigue, muscle or body aches, headache, loss of taste or smell, sore throat, congestion or runny nose, nausea or vomiting, and diarrhea. While a severe cough can lead to the taste of blood in your mouth, mainly due to the irritation or minor bleeding in the throat or gums, this symptom by itself is not indicative of COVID-19. However, if you're experiencing a persistent cough along with other COVID-19 symptoms, or if you've been exposed to the virus, it's crucial to get tested and consult a healthcare provider for appropriate guidance and treatment. It's also important to monitor your symptoms closely, as COVID-19 can affect individuals differently, and the presence of unique or severe symptoms warrants medical attention. Seeing a doctor for tasting blood when coughing is advisable when the symptom is persistent, accompanied by other concerning signs, or if you're unsure about its cause. If the taste of blood comes with actual blood in your sputum, especially in significant amounts or repeatedly, it's crucial to seek medical advice promptly. Other red flags include accompanying symptoms such as unexplained weight loss, chest pain, persistent fever, or difficulty breathing. These could indicate underlying conditions like infections, lung diseases, or even cardiovascular issues that need professional evaluation and treatment. Additionally, if you have existing health conditions like a history of respiratory diseases or immune system issues that could make you more susceptible to complications, consulting a healthcare provider becomes even more important. Remember, while tasting blood occasionally might not always be a sign of something serious, monitoring your symptoms or erring on the side of caution by getting a professional opinion is always the safest approach. So we've covered the various reasons why you might taste blood when you cough, ranging from the benign to the more serious. The key takeaway? Well, it's often not a sign of something dire. It's your body's way of saying, hey, something's up. Whether it's due to a dry throat, infection, or something more significant like lung conditions, it's important to listen to what your body is trying to tell you. If this taste of blood is more than a rare occurrence, it might be worth having a chat with your doctor. After all, understanding your body's signals is the first step towards taking care of your health. So let's keep the conversation with our bodies open and attentive. Your overall health is worth it. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. There should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you will enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.